Hello and welcome to ELT Cast, episode 115. ELT Cast is an educational podcast making English language teaching and learning more transparent. My name is Benjamin Stewart at BenjaminLStewart.net. Today I want to talk about my move back to RemNote and provide a little bit of context. Before I get into today's topic though, if you would like to reach out to me, if you have any thoughts, insights, or would like to share your experiences related to today's topic, feel free to reach out to me at my Twitter handle at BNLEEZ. So today I want to talk about RemNote and provide some context. The video that I created on February 12th, 2023, discussed my move from RemNote to Notion. And I want to do a follow-up video to explain my rationale, why I'm moving back to RemNote. In that video, where I discussed a little bit of frustration with RemNote, mainly had to do with the idea of sharing and resharing rems or notes. So in RemNote, a document, basically anything is referred to as a rem. It can be a document, it could be a bullet point or a series of bullet points. But one of the things that I find very valuable in RemNote is the ability to share rems with my students. And so I oftentimes will plan lessons, plan different activities, and basically share my planning and our activities that we do day to day, week to week, through RemNote. So it's very important for me to be able to share this information with students by clicking this option up here at the top right-hand corner of your screen here, this shared option. So the video that I created last February, I was going through some issues trying to reshare, more than anything, reshare rems, okay? And having updated rem be reflected in the moment when I reshared those documents. The issue wasn't so much the initial shared process. If I shared a document immediately, that was available typically to students. But if I were to go back and make changes to the rem and reshare it, there were some issues with those changes being reflected when students were accessing that information. That issue seems to be resolved at this point. Today's October 13th. They've made some improvements in that. I have found after I've completed 1 week of this fall 2023 semester, for the most part, most students are able to access REM and be able to access changed, you know, REM that had been changed and where I have reshared that information, those changes typically are reflected to students. I have had a couple of students have some issues accessing REM, but I don't think it's an issue. I don't think it's an issue on RemNote's side. I think, honestly, I'm not exactly sure what some of those issues were. That might be that the students need to eliminate the cache or maybe just clear their browser. Haven't really identified yet what that issue is, but out of the 90 students that I currently have for this semester, maybe 5 or 6 students had issues. So I want to talk about my current layout as an instructor. I am teaching English language teacher trainers. So students are studying and preparing to be teachers themselves, English teachers. And so when I share my information here, I typically organize it by semester. So on the left-hand side of my screen, you'll see that I have a REM document called Fall 2023, and I have currently the 3 courses that I'm teaching this semester that are located here in this space. There's a 4th course listed here, but this was a course that I was taking last month. So there are different ways that I can access this information. On the left-hand side, I can easily go directly to the course where I have all the course information, the general information, general description, general objective, and then I have the course content where students can access each week's module. So each week's module is a separate REM or a REM document. So all of this information is being shared to the students on the top right-hand corner of my screen. If I click share or reshare in this case, I can easily just copy this link over and make it available to my students. Now, one of the things that I have been exploring also in RemNote is the ability to add this same course content to groups. And they have made a lot of developments to their community, their RemNote community, where individuals can create their own profile and share different Rem and link it to their profile. So in my case, if I were to go into my profile, you'll see here that I have different documents, different Rem that are associated with my profile. This is still, I think, a work in process. And it's still, I think there are some improvements that can be made here, but you'll see that I have different groups now, and I'm experimenting this semester setting up groups for my courses. And for example, listening and speaking is a course I'm teaching this semester, and I can go in and look at different Rem that are that have been added to this group. And I can invite members, and I'm probably not going to explore too much the group feature at this point in RemNote. It would be nice later if there was a little bit more flexibility in how these documents could be arranged or maybe even created different categories within these groups so that this information could be organized in a way that maybe a course would be, you know, if I were to set up a course through a group, being able to organize these documents would be helpful. But just as a side note, there this feature does exist, and I anticipate a lot of changes in the future that maybe might make this a little bit more adaptable or flexible for those who want to set up a course as a group. But if I go back to my homepage here, and go into the course, and students can go in and go into each weekly module. So we just completed week one. So this is what week one, the module looks like. And all of my courses are set up in the same way. I have a Rem for that particular week. And within that Rem, I have by date, the information, the activities, the planning that pertains to that week. I have it organized by date. And so the way that I have this set up is I have dates, for example, August 7th, that also are linked to the actual journal. So if I go into today's note, there's a calendar feature that allows me to set up activities or actually work with Rem by setting up a different Rem through this particular journal. It's a journal feature that is presented by date. And so you'll notice here the first day of class was August 7th, and just below that I have references. And within those references, this is the same course content that is available if I were to go directly to the Rem itself. And I go in, so week one, for example, for listening and speaking one, these were the activities for that day. If I go in to August 7th, under references, I can also access that same information, which appears right here. Now, it looks a little bit different here because it's expanded, and that's why. If I go back, I can go back and expand this information. And I can show it'll appear the same here. And one of the hotkeys that I use quite a bit here is the expand feature, expand descendants. And this is all the information for that first day in expanded form. So I set up this by using the collapsed feature so that depending on if students want detail, they can access that. If not, I can minimize that or collapse it so that so that students and I can focus on different pieces of information. So that's why it looks different. But my point here is that there's different ways that you can, as a teacher, as an instructor, kind of enter into the same information, right? If this makes more sense to you to go into the actual week document and take it by course, if you are used to planning each of your courses and going in to each course and working, you can do that by setting up individual REM and going in it that way. Or if you just want to look at a general lesson plan for the day, then you can use the journal function going into today's note, and then just looking at that same information day to day. And I think having this option makes it quite easy, depending on your preference, depending on how your workflow is emerging throughout the semester, you have this option of doing both. So again, this is in the CLAPS feature, just so you know, this also works within the journal under references. I can also use this hotkey if I want to collapse all the information. I can do that also. So I can also expand and collapse the information. For some reason, it's not working at this point, but it did work earlier before I started recording this video. You should be able to also collapse the information, and it has worked in the past. Let me try it here. Okay, so this collapses all the information. CC or ED expands all of the information for that day. So again, if you are used to working and want to see all of the information that you're working on for that particular day for all the classes, then you have this option of using the journal, going to today's note, and going under references, and all that information links. Now, in order for this to happen, if you want this to appear in your journal, the only thing you need to do is make sure that you have included the date, as I've done here, and then make sure that all of the course content is embedded under that particular day. So you'll notice it's indented within the day, and that otherwise it will not appear. If this all this information were not indented within this information within August 7th, then it would not appear. All right, so that's how I've set up this semester. And so far, the workflow has been very useful for me in terms of just having the different options of entering into the course content. Now, the last thing I'll mention here, and something I'm going to explore a little bit more this semester, is the use of flashcards. And one of the strong features that RemNote offers is the flashcards page or the flashcards function. And I'm not going to go into the details, but one of the things I'm working on, one of the projects, is to put some information together for TOEFL preparation. A lot of our students in our BA are preparing as well, in addition to their courses, preparing to pass a TOEFL requirement to be able to pass at a B2 advanced B2 level, the TOEFL exam. So I'm preparing kind of a tutorial. And one of the things that, one of the videos that I created this week was to explain the way that flashcards could be used in preparing for the TOEFL. And the example that I used going under grammar here was to look at the page for parts of speech. And within parts of speech, I included some flashcards where students can go in and use the flashcard feature and review some of the definitions for the different parts of speech. And I'm going to be using flashcards throughout this space for TOEFL preparation. And I think in addition to me as an instructor making this information available to students, I think more importantly, students themselves can create their own flashcards as they are taking different courses and trying to review and become more proficient in certain areas that they are using flashcards to review some of the key concepts, key terms that they're learning. So flashcards is something that I'm going to be exploring a little bit more this semester, both as an instructor and also as a way to encourage students to set up their own flashcards for their own study purposes. But certainly using RemNote and having that flashcard feature available is another good reason to use this platform for study purposes and as an instructor, in my case, making the course information available to my students and also to others who are interested. So I think I'll stop there. Today, I just wanted to give a general overview, explain my workflow currently for this semester and why I've decided to go back to RemNote, primarily because now the sharing and resharing feature seems to be fixed, seems to be working very well. And I think having students be able to access this course content, it makes my workflow a lot easier when I prepare my classes. And it just makes the whole process more fluid in terms of what we do, what I plan in class, what we do each day. And as we're making changes to the course content in RemNote, it just makes my job a little bit easier. And as I make it available, I have a lot of control over what I want to share with students and also what I want to keep private as an instructor. So I'm curious if you're using RemNote or any other platform, how you are making your lesson plans available to your students. I'm always interested in hearing how other instructors are using their current workflow. So feel free to reach out to me if you want to share any of your insights or experiences. You can contact me at my Twitter handle at BNLEEZ. You've been listening to ELT Cast, an educational podcast making English language teaching more transparent. Thanks for listening.